Hello and welcome to yet another exciting episode of The Property Show, your leading television show on all things property. Our focus today will be on new properties, changing the geography of Kenya's real estate industry as we know it, while at the same time providing excellent housing solutions for the industry. We'll also take a look at the memorable events that made 2016 a remarkable year. Kenya Power Connections, Safaricom strong data internet experience, and an interesting advice on home ownership. As always, here at The Property Show, we always have you covered. So relax and let's enjoy the show. Remember, there is something for everyone. Architects have described this project as a sophisticated family development, a masterpiece in the making, Amani Ridge. Let's have a look.
Amani Ridge is an extension of an earlier product that we had launched here at the Property Show called Amani Village. We were launching affordable luxury homes. The site is exactly 500 meters from the main Mombasa Road. So we are actually in the heart of Syokimau. It opens to Tamak, a road actually that is currently under construction by the county government of Machakos. With the Property Show experience, we're able to interact with a huge turnout of buyers in our open day. At the same time, we got a lot of feedback from our websites. Clients were looking for a particular product. In this particular case, we were looking for middle-class families and we wanted to elevate their standards. We were looking for a product that can be able to suit the middle class, but that is not as expensive. Our main theme actually in what we do is affordable luxury living. So as far as Amani Ridge is concerned, the entire project is a three-bedroom masterpiece of apartments with servant quarters. We have borrowed heavily from our architects, who are Egyptian architects, working in partnership with our local architects here. So we have brought a lot of Egyptian feel, which is pretty new, very fresh. Most Kenyans actually will be looking forward to this project. One of the things that we noted is that there's a big gap for the modern family. And the modern family is actually being left behind purely because of several factors. One, affordability of homes. You find that most homes are not affordable enough. Or number two, they are shortchanged in terms of the product. For us, the three-bedroom concept was ideal. Even the people who are living in the two bedrooms, as their family expands, they want to settle in a three-bedroom. Actually, we can qualify it for a four-bedroom. This is what you get in Kilimani, Kileleshwa, and other high-end areas. We are giving it to you in Syokimau, a three-bedroom apartment with servant quarter. One of the key things is a space. We are giving you 1,363 square foot of a unit. There is nobody else giving such a unit in this entire area of Syokimau. The other thing is the finishes. And so we want to give buyers a choice. There are many options out there. We're giving you a choice for a better place to live in. Over and above that, we have also accommodated several amenities that our buyers had asked us in our previous projects. They would like us to accommodate. So these are some of the things that you have brought in to this project. We are promising you that this is a much better package, as you have seen it from the fly-through. First and foremost, let me first go to what is common to most people, the children's play area. In this particular case, ours is a fully fitted children's play area. When we say fully fitted, we're talking about a common facility with all the amenities for the ideal child. They don't have to travel far and wide and pay heavy sums for them to experience, you know, normal fun, day-to-day fun. We have provided for it here. That's the first one. Number two, in this particular project, there are no dead spaces. We have interacted with, especially with the woman. Most of the times when houses are being bought, the lady is the one who determines, what do I want where? We have killed dead spaces in this house, all right? We have provided also two levels of security. There's the main level from the entrance and the second level from the main arch of this particular project. This is fresh. It has not been experienced before. Then we're also creating some water features around the project. And then trees, palm trees, to blend in with the Egyptian architecture. We want to bring in the theme of green into this particular project. All right, so these are some of the key things. Our driveways are Cabro paved, all of them, they are Cabro paved. And the branding of the project from the external facade of the walling, of the boundary walling, is something to look out for. From the architectural feel of the project, the houses or the blocks themselves, they are well organized to ensure that there are no dark areas. Everybody enjoys sunshine. Everybody is able to enjoy the sunset. At the same time that you're able to experience warmth or light from both your lounge areas and from your bedrooms also.
What is unique at Amani Ridge is the impeccable architectural design, perfect location, coupled with a borehole, backup generator, solar water heating, and excellent security. Next, Mavoko Park, one of those most sought-after properties.
Mavoko Park is located in Siokimau in a gated community. Each maisonette is beautifully designed with 4 and 5 bedrooms. Accommodation includes spacious living room and dining room, fitted kitchen with detached pantry, spacious ensuite master bedroom with walk-in closet, common bathroom with shower, family room, panoramic balcony, and dobi area with provisions for washing machine. Salient features include private garden, provision for exterior gas tank storage, Cabro paved driveways, underground and overhead water tanks, boundary wall with electric fence, borehole water system, mini shopping center, solar water heater, and advanced system for cable TV and internet.
Stands out at Mavoko Park is the modern kitchen design, spacious lounges, and private gardens, making it an ideal family home as well as a great investment. This is the real deal. Let's shift gears to the Jumia House Golf Tournament, where real estate players are being recognized for their contribution. Let's have a look.
Jumia House celebrated its third anniversary as a housing solution online. The event incorporated a golf competition that saw various real estate players compete in amateur golf. The night was the culmination of the event as the Jumia House awarded various companies for quality services in their respective fields.
You see, we have products for many classes. We have the high-end class, we have the middle class, and we have the low, okay, let me call them low-end. So every class has where you find them, right? So most of the people who come golfing are mid to high-end. So it's a good focus area where you can get that kind of market, which is good for some of our products, mainly the high-end to mid-end market. We have several developments in all areas. For example, we have apartments which are in Ruaka, that is, they're called the Alma. Currently, they're 55% sold, and they are only 5 months into construction. So that's just to show that there's demand in these areas. There was not enough supply in these areas. We have some developments in Karen. We have Situ Village, around 50 villas. We have Amara Ridge, which has like 10 villas. We have a master plan coming up in Athi River, which is supposed to have house more than 1,000 units. So we're just trying to find a way of bridging the demand and supply in this real estate market. I think the real estate is developing. If we look at like maybe the quality of housing that we had a while back, a few years ago, it's totally different. People are upgrading. They are bringing more quality into the aspect. So before, real estate was all about just giving housing to people. People have now brought up a quality aspect. People are coming up with new ways of ensuring people get value for money in the real estate industry. And if we go on with this trend, then I think there's a bright future for the real estate market.
WorldSmith is your strategic investment partner. Not only do we sell property or houses, but we also give you an investment opportunity. So we had a couple of products, sold out some. We're still working on more. And we've issued title to a couple of the products for those who have completed payments, of course. And we have ready title for each and every product that we have. Well, the good thing about WorldSmith is we've looked at the market from end to end, each and every individual from all walks of life. We have products that could fit anyone and could suit anyone. That's why you'd see us today at the golf tournament today, and you'll find us somewhere else tomorrow. And we have exactly what you need. We have something in Nanyuki that's amazing, something that's specifically for agribusiness. So you have the option of having a residential plot whereby you'd buy, maybe build, or for investment purposes as well, sell it later. Or you can also buy your plot and do agribusiness on it. So basically you get your land for as low as 270,000. And on an additional 300,000, you get to have a greenhouse on that property, of which is maintained by the WorldSmith, built and maintained by us. If you wish to have affordable housing, maybe not in Nanyuki, we have something in Kisaju as well. It's the affordable housing concept, whereby for as low as 1.8 million, you have your two-bedroom house. So if you wish to maybe have a house, I mean, we've got you sorted. If you wish to have a holiday home, we still have you sorted. If you wish to do agribusiness, we still have you sorted. And if you wish to buy for speculation, we still have you sorted.
For the best property developer 2016, the winner is Sultan Palace Development Limited. For the category of Best Mixed-Use Development 2016 is Tatu City. The winner for the Best Real Estate Agency 2016 is Remax Kenya. The winner for the Top Innovative Real Estate Brand 2016 is The WorldSmith.
Our very own Nancy Modoni was awarded the Lifetime Achievement Award. Property Show congratulates all the winners of the night.
Having worked for local banks and distinguished international organizations, she dared to follow her dream, where few have ventured and established what has now become a household name. And this year's Lifetime Achievement Award goes to none other than The Property Show with Nancy Muthoni. Congratulations.
Thank you, Jumia House, for recognizing the real estate players who are contributing to the changing real estate landscape. Are you interested in owning a home or just want to understand matters property? Drop us an email or visit our offices to find your dream home on our property catalog. Next, let's hear from the fastest wireless connection, the Safaricom 4G.
I heard about 4G from my friends and I think it's going to be efficient for me. I'm an entrepreneur and I want to switch to it for efficient browsing, to talk to my clients and to basically, because I'm young too, to browse. So I think 4G is going to be the way to go and I'm expecting so much from it than what I get from my 3G line. So I'd like to advise everyone out there, don't wait, do things faster, switch to 4G and let's all move together to the better option.
I shifted from 3G to 4G. It works wonders. I go on YouTube, I stream, especially for my business. I'm a baker, and I need to keep updated with the current trends of baking and also uploading my photos because my business is online. If you haven't shifted from 3G, go to any Safaricom shop and move from 3G to 4G.
Because I was looking for a 4G phone, I found the big box, had a 4G, Wi-Fi, and you could share with about 10 people. So I decided that instead of buying internet bundles for my family, I should buy the big box instead. Wi-Fi, you can share with for about 10 people. You can view the TV, and the TV is free.
To get hurt.
I'm doing my best, bro.
You need to remember that chapeau day with mom, remember?
Let me send you a video.
But I can't wait.
You have it. Watch it.
Come together as a team and fight for this club. Make sure that we're never...
What?
Do things faster. Do things Safaricom 4G.
You too can experience fast and seamless internet connection. Just visit any Safaricom outlet across the country and shift to 4G. looking to add a spark and brighten your home with accessories? Next, the Accessory Spots. Accessories give a warm and welcoming feel to a home. Books instantly personalize a room. If a surface is crying out for some interest, try adding a stack of books or just one great big coffee table book. Small decorative objects should be used in moderation. Choose pieces you love for their value because they have a meaning for you and because they serve a useful purpose. To me, a room doesn't feel finished without a living plant. Choose plants that will do well with light conditions in your room for the best results. Is a home makeover part of your New Year's resolution? Call on us or visit our offices. We'll connect you to interior designers who'll give you that wow factor. We take a short break. We'll be back with a captivating home ownership story. Don't go away. Welcome back. Isn't it annoying to come back home after a hard day to a blackout, and not because there is a power outage in the area, but because you have been disconnected? Next, let's hear the disconnection process.
How do you avoid a disconnection? Just pay your bill before your due date. If you pay your bill before your due date, we have a number of Kenyans who we have never gone into their compounds to disconnect because they are conscious of the fact that I use this service, I must pay for it. Pay your bill before the due date, we'll never come to disconnect you. However, when we come to disconnect you, please allow our teams to disconnect you. Nancy, you may not believe it, but a lot of our customers are too ready to offer a bribe to the agents that we send out to disconnect power to collect revenue for us. And maybe what I just want to encourage our customers on, instead of bribing the staff or the agent we send on site to ask for collection from you, please pay that money through M-Pesa or through Airtel Money. Just send it, because it doesn't make the situation better by you not paying today. Next month you'll still come.
Supposing I'm not able to pay, I'm going through a hard time, I owe you money, what would you do for me if I'm not able to pay?
If you really have a genuine scenario, come to the office. Don't negotiate with our field officers.
Okay.
Because the field officers have a target number to handle in a day. And each day they have a different area they are going to. If you make a negotiation with them, they will not remember. And for us, in the office, our system will be indicating your account as off, not on. So if we do, for example, the supervisor comes by sampling and finds that your power is on, we shall take it that you're having that power illegally. And the law allows us actually to prosecute you. And that takes us to the second phase. We have customers. We pay, and there are other people who walk around the estates called umeme, others call themselves steamer. These are not Kenya Power people. They walk around the estates asking if they can put power back for you at a small fee. If we find that you've reconnected yourself, self-reconnection means either you go and do it yourself, or you get somebody to do it for you illegally because you have not paid power yet. If we find you, we shall actually arrest you. How do we get this? We send supervisors to sample areas where we've disconnected.
How quickly do you disconnect?
each month. However, if by chance we don't come to your house for this connection, please just pay. We want to appeal to the moral of our customers. Just pay before we come.
If I don't have money, I've lost my job, I don't
have. If you have lost a job, then you know you're having a whole shift in your lifestyle. How often does somebody who has lost a job walk to Nakumat and request that they be given bread free as they look for a job, Nancy? We're just doing a business like Nakumat. How are we going to run our balance sheet? If we're going to have customers using power, which we pay for, we buy power, by the way.
You have
we
no
do
mercy. Have,
we do. However, your track record will dictate how we relate with you. If, for example, you have been a perpetual defaulter, would you want to negotiate slow payment for a perpetual defaulter? No. But if you have been a very good payer, your bills fall due, you pay, and you have a temporal scenario, true, we can discuss that you pay a small amount, but only for a small period of time, because you cannot continue accumulating the debt.
So you give me like a month, 2 months?
Maybe a month. Because, you know, every day, actually we are selling power to you. So if you're going to take 2 months and you're having a situation that you may not be able to come out of very soon, then your power will just continue accumulating. Then at the end of the day, we shall end up in arrears and you'll be in distress yourself. So to avoid that, it's good for you to pay your bills early. However, I want to repeat this. The law allows us to ask for a fine of 1,000,000 shillings in case we find you reconnecting your power illegally. And I said you, because you'll have paid somebody else to do it for you, who is not from Kenya Power. Please just avoid it. We just want to encourage our customers to avoid it.
Have you ever prosecuted anybody?
We do. We have prosecuted customers. Of course, not to the 1,000,000 tune, because you know now the actual prosecution is also at the discretion of the magistrate.
Yes.
But it doesn't. And then you, after the prosecution, you still pay the bill. So why not just pay the bill? And if we have disconnected you, please just respect it and stay off and look for money to come and pay. Electricity revenue collection is not a campaign. It's a daily thing. Every day. The only thing that maybe we are doing right now is that we are hearing of spots here and there of customers who have been arrested. We do that almost every day. That is our work. That is part of the cycle. Because, you know, Nancy, a lot of us, if you get onto a bus and the conductor fails to reach you before your stage, what percentage of Kenyans walk to go and say, how many? I think it's a very small percentage. And that's why we come back by your door to remind you that for what you have eaten or for the service we've given you, please pay. If you have any query on your bill, call. Our customer care number is ready, is available, and 9551 and the customer care email address. Send to us, we'll respond to it. Because you want you to be satisfied with the bill to make your payment easy.
Pay your electricity bills on time to avoid disconnection and inconveniences. Building a dream home is personal, and how do you know you're on the right track? Coming up, let's hear from Dr. Smith on how keeping a close eye on the construction team ultimately works.
What would you advise homeowners who are looking to buy or to build? What would you advise them not to do?
Not to be too abrupt. You've got to find some way with somebody who knows about building, who will go over it and find out, for instance, the plumbing and the electricity, if all those things are working properly. And of course, before that, you've got to start saving money and then see how much you really are going to have to invest in a house. And that's very hard to start saving money.
I've been responsible for renovating or building buildings in South Africa and Zimbabwe and Kenya and in the US. And I've done a lot of the work myself, particularly in the US. I did the work because labor is high. And that made it possible for us to sort of stair step. We started very simply. The house we got in Bulawayo without a down payment. However, the roof was leaking, the windows were broken, and the place was rather in a mess. But we got it very cheaply, and so we were able to start there. And then that helped us have funds to build Daystar up to get it started in Nairobi. And then when we moved back from here, the Lord very wonderfully compensated us for all we put in by having a train wreck, which the insurance paid off and made it possible for us to buy a house in Portland. It was old. It needed work. As I said, it was a century old. It was not quite that old when we bought it, but it was over that when we sold it. And so it was a matter of being willing to work, willing to landscape, willing to move rocks. At one point, I moved 14 tons of rock by hand three times in order to do landscaping in our yard. But doing that kind of thing gave us what we call sweat equity. And that enabled us eventually to do this. So we didn't start out this way. We started out by doing hard work and taking what was available and within our economic reach and then building from there. Again, step by step by step. Yeah.
Taking what was available economically.
That's right, exactly that.
And then we also learned to check the qualifications of the workers, because they would all say, okay, we've in our firm we've got six plumbers. And then as we watched them, we decided that they didn't have much training. They could present some papers, but we discovered that a lot of them didn't have practical work. We had some difficulties with plumbing and electricity here, and we had to have it done all over again. So if we were doing it again, we would ask to see real papers, and then we wouldn't have some of the mistakes. We've had several leaks because they kept firing the plumbers that they had. All in all, there were eight plumbers. And one by one, they were let go. And of course, when they were let go, there wasn't anybody that they could turn it over to, so they didn't know what all the other plumbers had done. So we learned some unfortunate things, which if we did it again, we'd be more careful.
I think new homeowners need to look very carefully and learn all they can about the footings and the foundations, because there are a lot of contractors will cheat on that, putting in less hardcore, weaker cement, and then you begin to see cracks developing. And sometimes I've known of cases where the concrete floor was poured with no foundation under it, no footings, and of course it was just on dirt. And when it rains, the rain soaks in, and then the floor is weakened and cracks. So you have to look very carefully and find out about what's not seen as well as what's visible.
So are you saying that it's important for people, if they're building, to also be very connected to what's going on the ground?
If possible, they're very much so. If they are not connected and not watching, or if they have a builder and an architect that they have total confidence in, that's fine. But there are a lot of people who claim more than they can deliver.
Yes. What about finances? Did you build this within your budget?
Yes, we did. Good. We built it within our budget because of the chain of events over the years. We first owned a home in Bulawayo. That was in 1964. And so we built step by step from that time. And we were building Daystar simultaneously. And as I said, we poured all of our funds beyond what we needed to live on in getting Daystar underway. Now, of course, after it started, other people came along and gave gifts, primarily from the US, Canada, England, Germany, even Japan, in building the buildings of Daystar. Yeah. But it had to be started before they could do that.
Yes, it has. And I think the hardest is to believe in the vision and believe in that dream and to start.
Well, we count it a tremendous privilege. And we look at what's happened in Daystar and we are very, very thankful.
That you're part of making history.
What were the pros and cons when building your dream home? Connect with us and share that experience. Here at The Property Show, we keep you informed on everything happening in the real estate world. Next, highlights of an upcoming diaspora conference expected to change the real estate narrative globally. Let's watch.
We are hosting the Invest in Africa conference. The conference is about changing the narrative because North Americans sometimes think that Africa is a black continent. So we want to change that narrative. We want to tell the story differently. And we want to have professionals like yourself actually come and tell your story and also bring your project owners to tell their story or present their projects and invite others in other sectors to tell this new story of what's happening on the continent, because we're definitely having 6 to 7% return year on year, which is good for the continent, good for the country, even Kenya. And Kenya has moved 6 points up actually when it comes to investments. So it's a very interesting market. It's a very interesting time. And I think it is time for Africans to step out and showcase what they're doing back home to the diaspora market as well as the international investor market.
So this conference, you'll be attracting international investors?
Yes.
As well as Kenyans living in Canada?
Yes, who are, in my view, they're Canadians, but they're Kenyan Canadians, and so they're very interested also in making an investment in Kenya.
We, as Property Show, will come with our developers.
Right.
What should they be expecting?
There are two things that should be expected. The first part is pre-coming. We should already have our ducks in a row. We should do all the due diligence, we should do all the packaging of the deals, make sure that the deals meet the Canadian investor criteria, because they are Canadian investor criteria or North American investor criteria. A lot of the investors who invest in North America, whether Canada or the US, are actually accredited investors. So we need to make sure that we are meeting the requirements of what they would be expecting to see in a project. So we're constantly engaging with investors, we're engaging them for different types of projects. Our responsibility is really to match investors to projects or projects to investors. And we do have a very, very clear methodology and process on how we do that. So there's a due diligence, there's actually fact-finding and identifying the right projects on both sides. So we need to be able to satisfy not just the person with a project, but we also need to satisfy the person who's got their money, who's investing. And so we put in place mechanisms, and we even have a website that has a lot of the processes that we actually engage pre, and then we have the activities that we have to engage post the engagement. But the main success criteria, number one, is that there has to be a very good understanding of what the investor is looking for.
So are you going to give us
The pre-planning is
the
about
pre-planning
packaging.
We'll be able to package that.
Exactly.
So we will
staging. In fact, we would call it investor staging.
So the investor staging will be able to tell me, you'll be able to tell us our investors are looking for ABC.
Right.
Then from our pool of developments, we'll be able to pull what your investors are looking
actually,
for.
Actually, we might do it the other way around. We'll identify the projects. We'll take them through a due diligence process, and then we'll pick what we know for sure
will cut it through on the other side. That would be the best approach. Yes. So that we give everybody a chance, and there's a very straightforward mechanism of doing that. So we just need to put time aside and do the DD, and then, and I've already started talking to some of your customers actually. Yes. So we already are having conversations about how to pre-package and how to stage the projects before we actually get to Toronto for the conference.
Fantastic. Yeah. Who are the other players coming along?
Okay, so we have people from the renewable energy sector. We have, there'll be another mining conference that's ongoing, so I'm not going to highlight too much about the mining, but there'll be engagement between our conference and the mining conference. And then we have agriculture, we have retail. Most of the retail products or the SMEs are basically within insurance, financial services. That's where most people are looking for money. There's the credit microfinance companies that are also looking for money. There's mortgage companies that are also looking for money. So those types of people will be there. And then we'll also engage with some of the PPP, the Kenya PPP unit. Hopefully will also be present to present some of their own projects. So there's anywhere between dealing with projects like student housing as one example, and then there will be opportunities to deal with hospital facilities that the Kenya National Hospital are actually looking to run some projects. So there are several things that are ongoing. These are things that are still under discussion. So we're doing public projects, and we're also doing private projects.
And what dates are we looking at?
We're looking at March 7th and 8th, 2017, in Toronto. And we're very excited to have...
people who are watching you today,
yes,
who are wondering, how can I plug in? What
please just go to Africa Expert Forum. That's the website, africaexpertforum.com. You will see that on the side banner, you'll see the forum 2017. Click on there. You see all the information about the sponsorships, you see information of speakers, you see everything you need to see, including how to register to attend. And then you can also email me, and you can also write to us, and all the details are on the site.
And are you in Nairobi, or where are you based? Are you based?
We're based in Toronto. Uh-huh. We are incorporated in Canada. We have a federal registration across Canada, but our office is domiciled in Toronto, in the province of Ontario. We've been around for 4 years, and we continue to do the work that we do, not just in Kenya, but also in Zambia, and we have a team representation in Ghana, and we're working with our relationships in DRC, Congo, as well as Ethiopia and East Africa through your office.
Wow.
Yeah, and other partners.
Thank you so much. That's a lovely story.
Yeah.
And we look forward to coming to Canada. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Next month, we also have the Upmarket Homes Expo in Karen. Registration is ongoing. Book your stand today.
The Upmarket Homes Expo 2017 is the inaugural event for high-end property. The Upmarket Homes Expo promises to deliver new concepts and ideas for the property industry. The expo will be held at the Hub Karen from the 24th to the 26th of February 2017. Be a part of this expo to do business, showcase signature properties, and meet future clients. Book a booth now.
And finally, the bus tour is around the corner. This time we are visiting upcoming properties in every price range in new neighborhoods. Why the bus tour, you may ask? The tour gives us an opportunity to see different properties in different locations, compare prices, the product, and a chance to engage with legal and financial experts. The bus tour also gives us a chance to understand the complicated process of owning a home, as well as investing in the real estate industry. Book your seat today. Thank you for watching. We've come to the end of today's show. See you next Sunday, same time, same place, for another insightful episode. Share your thoughts and comments on our social media pages and we'll be happy to engage. As always, your property search starts right here. Remember, there is something for everyone. Kwaheri!